Hi there, and today I'm going to show you how you can set up your own ADB bridge. So what you want to do is you want to head to developer.android.com/studio/index.html. Now, this is what it looks like at the top. If you scroll down and keep scrolling, you can see it says select different platform. And where it says get the command line tools, that's the ADB bridge. So if you click your appropriate operating system, so I'm Windows, so I'm going to click Windows, and then you're just going to accept the terms and conditions. Okay, now it's finished downloading, we're going to click on it, and we're just going to open that standalone exe file. And there you go, you can see the setup popping up now. So now it's open, and we're just going to go through. You're going to click next, and then you're just going to scroll through this, and yeah, you're going to click install. And we're going to click finish, and we want to make sure it's ticked to start the SDK manager. And we just click finish. And here we go, it's booting up. Okay, now we've finished loading. We're just going to, because we don't want to actually use the SDK to develop apps, we don't need to use this Android development kits for the different versions of Android and APIs. So we're just going to use the tools. So we'll just use these tools. We're just going to click install, and we'll click accept license, and you're just going to go down to the bottom, and you're just going to click accept license also. Now I'm going to click install. Once you've finished the SDK, downloading all the platform tools and build tools you want to use, you're going to head to your file manager. You're going to go this PC, you're going to go to C drive, you're going to go users, Samlo, or whatever your username is, and then this is app data, it might be hidden. I'm going to click on that. Might have to unhide it, or show hidden folders, potentially. Go on this, Android SDK, platform tools. So if you go control shift right click, and it says open command window here, click that, and now you have actually got ADB bridge working. So that's how it works, and you can now I'll plug something into my computer, for example. And now if you to check for your devices, so that's me, Samuel, what you're actually going to do is you're going to type in ADB devices, click enter, and any devices that you have on the computer or plugged in should show up, and you can see me there. I'm this random number here. So if you go ADB-S and then type in that 330CB7431B 662D7, and then you type shell, you should now, if you wait, I'll show you what happens. And now you have control of the device through the shell, and you can do some cool things with this, and I'll show you some more things about what you can actually do with inputs. For example, you can input text into the phone. For example, I could be hello, and hello would actually show up on the phone. Sorry about that. So that's how it works. I'll show you some more in other videos. Please like the video if you want to see more of this. Comment down what you actually want me to do in terms of ADB or anything like that, because I have had a few requests for ADB. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. So thank you. Goodbye.